In this video, I'll show you how to withdraw money from Binance to Mpesa step by step. This is the web-based tutorial, and if you'd like to see the mobile version, I do have a tutorial on that as well. So I've got Binance open up and I'm logged in. So as you can see, I have about 84 USDT, more or less equal to $84. Now, for me to be able to send this money or receive this money via Mpesa, I'll need to open up more or less of a trade. If I go up here, there's this option for trade, and then you'll see P2P right here. So I can click on that, and from here, you're going to land on this option. So you can either find an ad, but I'll close this. And from here, there are different currencies that are available. So I'll click on sell, and we have USDT, that's what I have. Let's not show the notifications, but I'll click on this and add KES for shillings. So welcome to Cashstone. Things to know before you start. Please read the advertiser's terms of trade carefully and make payment using payment method specified in the ad. Users are not allowed to charge any extra fees. The price in the ad should be final. To avoid becoming a victim of scammers, never transact. Read more. Never transfer crypto before actually receiving the payment. The seller must check the receipt of payment in his bank account before releasing the crypto. Don't believe anyone who claims to be customer support and convinces you to complete the transaction before you receive the payment. They're scammers. Once the seller confirms the order and transfers the assets to the buyer, the transaction is considered completed and cannot be disputed. Binance does not take any responsibility for transactions made outside the platform. So I have read and agreed to the above content. Click on start trading. And from here, I can now choose or filter the payment method I want. As you can see, you can already see some of the more popular payment systems, Mpesa Kenya by Safaricom. So I'll actually select that. It's a good option. Now, from here, you can now see people with promoted ads. And right off the bat, I can almost tell you this one, as much as they've done so many orders, the rate they're offering is very, very low. It's not the best rate right there. So you can actually just check around and see if you can find somebody you can trade with right here. So you can see what some, this is actually a bronze merchant, a gold merchant, and you can see the rates that they're offering. So this one is doing in about 45 minutes, some in more or less faster, 15 minutes. And you can see some are actually restricted. Why? I don't know, but you can actually keep checking to see if you're actually going to see somebody you can trade with whatever coin that you have. So you can keep checking. Let's go to page 2 and see what's there. Scroll down and you can see a couple of options here. So for example, I know I've traded with this one before. I can actually see what their more or less their profile looks like. So you can see when they joined, everything, deposits. So you can see USDT. You can buy. Let's close this. But let's go back. Because I want to sell. And I've already worked with this one trader. Let's go to page 2. Biala. And they were really, really fast. So take a note that they do keep changing. Let's go to page 3. So they're now on page 3. And what I'm going to do now, because I've already worked with them before, I'm actually going to click on sell USDT. From here, you can kind of see they did not set any terms. I want to sell all. I want to sell all. And then this is the amount I'm going to receive. And then my number is right there because I've already done a trade before. So I'll click on sell USDT. Successfully placed. So you're going to see their name. And then I've created an order. And you actually get this particular message right there. letting you know not to release any funds until the order is kind of completed or something. So there we go, I've placed an order. Let me see if they're actually going to process a particular order again, because they were really, really fast in the most recent trade that I did with them. So if the trade is taking too long, you can also send them a chat message to kind of tell them, hey, I have this trade going on, can you process it? So I have placed the sell order for 10.7. Please send payment to M-Pesa number shown. I will release the crypto as soon as I confirm the M-Pesa transaction ID. So the transaction has been done, and there we have it. So there we go. Payment received. And once I do that, I have verified that I received XYZ. I can confirm release on that amount. Let's do authenticator app. And then I'll get the code from the authenticator app right here. So we can also do email. I think they also want me to do email verification. So there we have it. Rate your P2P experience. It was good, more or less. Very satisfied. Very satisfied. Yeah. So now when we go back to more or less our homepage right here, our dashboard, you're actually now going to see that the balance that I have is zero. And if I can actually go to the side right here, more or less like asset history and orders and whatever, you can see that I received some amount here, changed from the spot to funding, completed the transaction, completed this P2P sale, that is from Binance to M-Pesa, and then did it again. If I go back even to the homepage, you're actually now going to see that my balance is 00 USDT, and that is how you can withdraw money from Binance to M-Pesa via the website option. I do have a tutorial on the Binance app option. It's more or less the same. Just do your due diligence to avoid being scammed, and also look at the rates that the different people are offering. That's it for this video. I hope it's of value to you. Thanks for watching.